एंटी इपिलेप्टिक ड्रग्स, द ड्रग्स व्हिच आर यूज्ड इन द मैनेजमेंट ऑफ इपिलेप्सी. देर आर थ्री डिफरेंट टर्म्स फॉर द इपिलेप्सी. इपिलेप्सी इटसेल्फ, कन्वल्जन एंड द सीजर्स. दिस थ्री टर्म्स आर सिमिलर. सीजर्स एंड इपिलेप्सी बोथ आर सेम एज द इपिलेप्सी इज द न्यूरोलॉजिक डिसऑर्डर ड्यू टू डीपोलराइजेशन ऑफ द न्यूरॉन्स एंड द कन्वल्जन. Convulsion is not always means the epilepsy, because the convulsions may be due to some medical conditions. Convulsion may occur due to some medical conditions. So when there is a convulsion, it may be not the epilepsy, but maybe convulsion may be due to some medical conditions, maybe use of some drugs, or maybe due to fever. But epilepsy is an neurological conditions. The objectives of today's lecture is list the drugs which are used in treatment of epilepsy, describe the pharmacology of anti-epileptic drugs, design a plan for treating different types of epilepsy, and list the tests required to monitor therapy of different cases of epilepsy and prescription of different cases of epilepsy. These cases, last two objectives, we will discuss in the therapeutics probably. Let us move towards the first objective, the anti-epileptic drugs with mechanism of actions. Generally, what happen in the epilepsy? As we know that the epilepsy is a depolarization. Epilepsy is a depolarization of the neuron. So you should know the term about what is depolarization, what happened actually in epilepsy, and what is our target for the management. Depolarization, generally what happen at the resting state of our cell, when our cell is at a resting cell potential, the inside of the cell membrane is negatively charged. Inside of the cell membrane is negatively charged. And when there is a depolarization occurs, the sodium channel opens and the positively charged ion comes inside the cell. The positively charged ion, including sodium, enters inside the cell, and due to this positively charged ion, the negativity of the cell is decreased, and it leads to the depolarization, and we can say excitation, what happens in the epilepsy. So depolarization means when the positively charged ion enters the cell membrane and it causes negativity in the membrane potential, and due to this increase in the negativity, there is an excitation and the epileptic symptoms. But sometimes what happen, generally epilepsy most last about 2 minutes, 5 minutes, 10 seconds, and this sodium channel gate is self-limiting. After some time, after 10 seconds or 2 minutes or after 5 minutes, it is close the gate, and when the gate automatically closed, the sodium channel is sodium ions are not able to enter the cell, membrane potential and the symptoms of the depolarization will lost. So what is our target here? Generally, we are using sodium channel blocker, potassium channel blocker, and as we know that this sodium channel blocker and the potassium channel opener, when there is a sodium channel blocker, our aim is here to stop the entry of positively charged ion, including sodium, enters into the cell membrane, and to stabilize the resting potential of the, or we can say to maintain the membrane potential at resting state. So here the role of sodium is very important. When we block the channel, the sodium ions, or we can say positively charged ion, is not able to enter the cell membrane, and they will maintain the membrane potential at resting state and at more towards the negatively charged. And examples of these drugs are the carbamazepine, phenytoin, fosphenytoin, oxcarbazepine, lamotrigine, zonisamide, lacosamide, and islicarbazepine. Now, these two drugs are new, the blue color drugs. These are, we can say, third generation or the newer anti-epileptic drugs. GABA receptor agonist, as we know that the GABA is gamma-aminobutyric acid, is a neurotransmitter, and we can say it is one of the inhibitory neurotransmitter, and the role here to inhibits the neuron, including clobazam, clonazepam, phenobarbital, primidone, and the benzodiazepines. Phenobarbital, phenobarbitone, you studied in the general anesthetic medications, and benzodiazepines you studied in the sedative hypnotics, benzodiazepines, including diazepam, lorazepam, and the midazolams. Third category is GABA reuptake inhibitor, gamma-aminobutyric acid reuptake inhibitor. Reuptake inhibitor, if it is reuptake inhibitor, so it does not allow to reuptake by the neurons and therefore increase the concentration of the GABA at postsynaptic membrane and stabilize the, we can say, stabilize, or it may lead to the hyperpolarization. Now, what is depolarization and the hyperpolarization? These two terminologies are very important. Depolarization, as I said to you, when positively charged ion enters into the cell membrane and the negativity of the cell membrane is decreased, we can say it becomes more positive, and the excitation occurs, the epileptic symptoms occurs, we can say depolarization. And hyperpolarization, it is opposite to the depolarization. And in hyperpolarization, the positively charged ion, we have to excrete, we have to remove from the cell membrane towards the outside the cell. Outflow of the positively charged ion from the cell is known as hyperpolarization, in which the cell membrane is with the more negatively charged ions. So this drug, we can say indirectly, they causes the hyperpolarization of the cell membrane. The anti-epileptic drugs generally causes hyperpolarization of the cell membrane. Then GABA transaminase inhibitors, as the enzyme transaminase is responsible to inhibits the GABA we have to save the GABA here for the inhibitor reactions. That's why we need the GABA transaminase inhibitors. An example is vigabatrin. Anti-epileptic drugs with potential GABA mechanism of action, they having the powerful gamma aminobutyric acid actions, and examples are the valproate, gabapentin, pregabalin. Glutamate blockers, topiramate, felbamate, and pirampanel. Neuronal potassium channel opener. Now here the role of potassium is very important. It is generally counteract with the sodium. Potassium channel opener. When the potassium channel opens, the positively charged ion outflows out of the cell membrane and it causes the hyperpolarization. And anti-epileptic drugs with miscellaneous mechanism of actions. This includes levetiracetam, brivaracetam, rufinamide, and the ethosuximide. And the devices available to manage the epilepsy, it is, if the epilepsy is not managed by the drugs, then devices includes the vagus nerve stimulation and responsive neurostimulations. Now, if we see how many drugs for the management of the epilepsy, and obviously there are total 22 drugs are available for the management of the epilepsy. 22 different medications, and these are classified as old, newer, and the newest. If you see, the in 1912, the phenobarbital, the first drug used in the treatment of the epilepsy, management of epilepsy. After that, phenytoin. So if you see, the phenytoin and the phenobarbital, these are from how many years? 1912 and 1938. Then primidone, it is on the 54, ethosuximide, carbamazepine, valproic acid, and these old medications all are the still in the use, and we can say these are still the first line agents, or we can say these drugs are the preferred medication in the management of the epilepsy. Then after 90s, there are some newer drugs. At 1993, there is a felbamate, gabapentin, lamotrigine, topiramate, tigabatin, levetiracetam, oxcarbazepine, zonisamide. And after 2000, the newest, we get the pregabalin, rufinamide, lacosamide, vigabatrin, clobazam, isogabine, pirampanel, and islicarbamazepine, the newest one, which is generally approved in the 2014. So these are, we can say, also the third generation anticonvulsants. These are the third generation anticonvulsants, including lacosamide, sodium channel, act via the sodium channel, islicarbamazepine, act via sodium channel, isogabine, act via potassium channel activator, and the pirampanel, act via glutamate antagonist. So there are many medications, but we will see which are the preferred one and which are the best one and still used in the management of epilepsy. Let us see one by one. Now, before going to the pharmacology of the drugs, we will see which are the preferred drugs used in the management of epilepsy. See, this is the chart, and it gives the details about the out of these 22 drugs. And if you see the chart very carefully, there are only six drugs which are commonly used. We can say these drugs are preferred, found useful in the management of the epilepsy and according to the types of the epilepsy. Let us see first one, the types of epilepsy, the partial epilepsy or the focal epilepsy. As the name indicates, it is only on the specific part of the brain. So partial, focal, frontal part of the brain. And there is two types of the epilepsy, simple and the complex. Simple partial epilepsy is without the loss of consciousness, and the complex partial epilepsy, it may lead to the loss of consciousness. Which are the preferred drug? Carbamazepine, phenytoin. Or not with the, not in the combination. You can prescribe either carbamazepine or phenytoin. And if the patient is not able to get benefit from this drug, or patient has contraindications or hypersensitivity with this preferred category of drug, you can prescribe alternative drugs including valproic acid, phenobarbital and the primidone. For the complex, the drugs are same, carbamazepine, phenytoin. And if the drug is contraindicated, having the hypersensitivity, you can use alternative drug, valproic acid, primidone. In the case of the generalized epilepsy, for the tonic clonic, or we can say grand mal epilepsy, generalized, now it includes the whole brain. Tonic clonic or the grand mal epilepsy, the preferred drug is again carbamazepine and the phenytoin. And if the patient has the documented hypersensitivity, or we can say contraindications, or patient not get the benefits from this drug, you have the alternate choice, valproic acid, phenobarbital, and the primidone. For the absence or petite mal epilepsy, and this type of epilepsy generally occur in the children from 2 to 12 years of the age, and the preferred drug, ethosuximide. So if you see, ethosuximide is only used in the management of petite mal epilepsy, or we can say absence epilepsy. You didn't find ethosuximide in other categories. Only one category, that is absence or petite mal epilepsy, ethosuximide. So remember for these questions, maybe for your exam point of view, the ethosuximide only for absence or petite mal seizure. Alternative drug for the petite mal or absence seizures includes the valproic acid, clonazepam. For the myoclonic, the preferred drug is valproic acid and alternative drug is clonazepam. Febrile seizures in the children. Febrile seizures means maybe due to the fever or maybe due to the infections. The drug of choice for this febrile seizure is phenobarbital. And alternate drug is primidone. And the status epilepticus, which is generally we can say medical emergency. In the status epilepticus, the seizure may last for 5 minutes with the loss of consciousness, or maybe within the 5 minutes, there is 2 to 3 times attack of the seizures. So status epilepticus is a medical emergency, and the preferred drugs here needs the diazepam and the phenytoin, and alternative drug is phenobarbital. So out of 22 drugs, if you see here, only the 6 drugs are used. Carbamazepine 1, phenytoin 2, third one is ethosuximide, fourth one is valproic acid, fifth one is diazepam, and sixth one is phenobarbital. These are the 6 drugs which are commonly used in the first line or preferred category of the drugs. Let us see one by one the pharmacology of the most preferred drugs in the management of the epilepsy. First one is phenytoin, and the Dilantin is a famous brand name of the phenytoin. Mechanism of actions. Now, as we know that the epilepsy is due to the depolarization of the neuron. And what is the depolarization? When sodium ion influx into the cell membrane, when the sodium ion influx into the cell membrane and the cell membrane become more positively charged. So our aim here is to efflux, remove the sodium ion from the cell membrane. And the, what is the category of phenytoin? Phenytoin here is sodium channel blocker, block the sodium channel and stop the entry. So what is the mechanism of phenytoin? It promotes the sodium efflux, sodium ion efflux, efflux and influx. See, this is a two terminology here. If you see this, this is the efflux. Efflux means outside the cell, outside the cell. And influx means inside the cell, inside. So the phenytoin promotes the efflux, outflow of the sodium ion from the cell and decrease the sodium influx, and the it's inhibits the entry of sodium ion into the cell membrane. From membrane in motor cortex neuron, stabilizes the neuronal membrane and slows the conduction velocity and stabilize the action potential, we can say. So our aim is here, just remember, sodium ion efflux or sodium ion decrease the sodium ion influx and increase, or we can say promote, the sodium ion efflux. Now distribution, generally the phenytoin is 95% bound to the plasma protein and only 5% of the drug is free. And you should know, if the only 5% drug is free and it is responsible for the pharmacological action, as we know that only the free drugs are responsible for the pharmacological action. And if we give any drug with the phenytoin to the patient of the epilepsy, and if there is a drug-drug interaction will occur, and if one drug may displace this phenytoin from the plasma protein binding, and the, if the free drug concentration will increase, it may lead to toxicity or adverse effect. Metabolism. Phenytoin is metabolized by hepatic 450 enzyme, cytochrome family, generally by the cytochrome 2C9, and metabolites is inactive. The half-life is near about 22 hours if it is taken by oral route, and 10 to 15 hours if it is taken by intravenous route. And excretion is most of the by the urine route.